Hello everybody. In this presentation, I'm going to discuss the findings of my dissertation study. My dissertation comprised of three studies that explored the effectiveness of digital games in producing pro-environmental attitudes and behaviors. The title of this presentation is Digital Games for Environmental Sustainability Education, Implications for Educators. All the three studies in my dissertation used a game called Inner Cities, in which players had to build a sustainable city. Providing awareness about environmental sustainability is not enough. Although people are eco-aware, they do not perform pro-environmental behaviors because of several barriers and negative perceptions. We need to implement a persuasive pedagogical tool that helps learners break barriers and perform pro-environmental behaviors. We as educators need to go beyond providing cognitive knowledge and promote attitudinal learning. Attitudinal learning is comprised of cognitive, affective, behavioral, and social learning. My dissertation studies explored whether a digital game was effective in producing pro-environmental friendly attitudes and behavioral intentions and how it produced this attitudinal learning and the learning retention. From the studies, I found that the game Inner Cities did enhance the eco-awareness of all players by immersing them in the game. All players took responsibility for what happened within the game because they were able to see the consequences of their actions in real time. Because of this, they developed empathetic feelings for the human and non-human world in the game. This got transferred to their feelings about the real world. Their thinking went beyond the 3 R's of environmental sustainability, that is, reduce, recycle, and reuse, and they learned to refuse. Before playing the game, they thought that development of their city means the construction of beautiful and tall buildings. However, after playing the game, they learned that true development comprised a balance with nature where people were happy, the environment was safe to live in, and sustainable. So from these findings, I have the following recommendations for educators. Instructors have to select games that are focused on the learning goals. Games should provide knowledge in the form of prompts. Learners should understand the interrelationships between events in any environment. Game mechanics and features should build empathy by enabling players to examine the consequences of their actions in real time. Also, instructors can allow collaborative and individual gameplay. In one study, I found that attitudinal learning was similar whether the games were played in teams of two or whether it was played individually. Before implementing games, instructors should explore various games that are available. They should play the game once or twice to become familiar with it. Also, it is better to select games that align with the curriculum and the learning objectives. An instructor should also consider issues such as internet connectivity, affordability, cybersecurity, and parental permission. Quizzes and exams will help assess cognitive knowledge but not attitudes. Hence, to assess environmental attitudes, instructors must use instruments such as the New Ecological Paradigm Scale, the Attitudinal Learning Instrument, or a survey based on the theory of planned behavior. To sum up, I would like to share a quote from one of the participants. There are many disasters happening. I thought that I couldn't do anything, but after playing the game, I took a decision. I could do something good to the earth. Even if a single small contribution, it is a big thing to the earth to save the earth. I believe that this is the kind of realization we have to instill in our young learners and help them understand that the environment is not ours to take or leave, it is ours to make. Thank you.